once a slave in Egypt, I lived in poverty. Then I heard a voice saying, son, I have so much more. Then he led me to a land where manna from above, he fed me every day. But he said, don't store for tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll provide again. From the land of not enough, to the land of just enough, to the land of milk and honey. Fire by night and cloud by day, trusting, learning to obey, till we reach the land of promise. No more chains, I've been set free. Now every day he meets my needs. Hand in hand we'll make the journey. From the land of not enough, to the land of just enough, to the land of milk and honey. Now every day he leads me. We're getting closer to the land of promise, where we'll never want again. But I thank him every single day. I thank him for my valleys and all the storms and trials and tests that he's brought me through. For the land of milk and honey is a land just up ahead. From the land of not enough, to the land of just enough, to the land of milk and honey. Fire by night and cloud by day, trusting, learning to obey, till we reach the land of promise. No more chains, I've been set free. Now every day he meets my needs. Hand in hand we'll make the journey. From the land of not enough, to the land of just enough, the land of milk and honey. From the land of not enough, to the land of just enough, to the land of milk and honey. Thank you, Lord. Somebody say thank you, Lord. You brought your dancing shoes. Come on, get your hands together now. When God's people come together, all in one accord, wonderful things, they've just got to happen. As His presence fills the room, and right now I am expecting something special, something good, 'cause we're together. We're praising the Lord. people got together in the upper room. They were waiting on the promise of what Jesus said he would do. And the power fell from heaven. Oh, the joy it did import. They were together back then. And guess what they were doing? They were praising the Lord. Now we're together again. Praising the Lord. Together again, in one accord. Something good is gonna happen. Something good is in store. 'Cause we're together again, and we're praising the Lord. Yes, we're together again, praising the Lord. From Nashville, so we're gonna give you a little country. Is that okay? Y'all like country in Texas? I just feel like something good is about to happen. I just feel like something good is on its way. He has promised that he'd open all of heaven. And brother, it could happen any day. When God's people humble themselves and call on Jesus, and they look to heaven expecting as they pray, I just feel like something good is about to happen. And brother, this could be that very day. Listen up. Yes, I've read of all the bad news in the paper, it seems like things are bleaker every day. But for this child of God, it makes no difference, for I know it's bound to get better either way. He has promised I nor ear can hardly fathom all the things he has in store for those who pray. Algo bueno tiene Dios para su pueblo. Algo bueno para ti Él preparó. Sus promesas todas ya se han cumplido. Las ventanas de los cielos ya abrió. Cuando dos o tres estén de un acuerdo, bendiciones Él promete derramar. Algo bueno tiene Dios para su pueblo. Hermano, solo hay que aceptar. Well, I just feel like something good is about to happen. I just feel like something good is on its way. He has promised that he'd open all of heaven. Yes, he has. And brother, it could happen any day. When God's people humble themselves and call on Jesus, and they look to heaven expecting as they pray, I just feel like something good is about to happen. And brother, could be that very day. I just feel like something. about to happen. And brother, this could be. Sister, this could be. Brother, this could be that very day. Good to be in the presence of the Lord this morning.
Amen, amen.
You know, Pastor, last week I completely lost my voice.
Yes.
And I went to sing and I'd open my mouth, nothing come out. And I felt so bad that I could not deliver the message to the people in the way that it should be delivered, that when I started singing this morning, I said, I got my voice back. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo! Thank you, Jesus. It's good to be here this morning with you. As Brother Josh said, I've known their dad, Danny and Dora, here for a long time. I thought you asked, how long, brother? Our pictures in our yearbooks.
And Brother Danny's?
Yeah, Danny and I's picture in our yearbook, Jesus' picture is in there. Moses and all that. Oh, no, but it's good. It's good to be here this morning. Yes, we thank the Lord for all his blessings. It's good to be in Dallas, Texas again. We lived here in DeSoto, actually, for several years when I first joined the Galileans. But I don't remember it being this hot. Man, it is hot. Wow.
You know what? We better think about the place that people go.
Oh, I tell you, man, this is too hot.
This is hot. But can you imagine it's going to be hotter in hell?
I don't want to imagine because I'm not
going
there. I
don't want to go there. I don't know about you. How many of you want to go to hell?
No.
Well, then let's get with it.
Oh, my.
And let's start worshiping and praising and telling people about Jesus.
Honey, there's a song that you sing that I just love for you to sing this morning. It talks about the fact that Jesus is alive.
Ooh, yes.
I said he's alive.
Yes, he is.
He's alive. He lives today.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
Mary came unto the tomb of Jesus. The stone was rolled. Risen, this she heard him say.
Yeah.
Go on, the stone is rolled and gone. The tomb is empty, gone to sit at his father's side. Go on, over death triumphant.
Father's son, God, over death triumphant, God, sin is defeated.
the stone is rolled and gone. That tomb is empty, gone. To say that his father's son, gone. Over death triumphing, gone. Sin is defeated, gone. He lives forevermore.
Gone. He lives forevermore.
He lives forevermore.
Somebody say,
hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we worship you, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, my Lord. I love you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thine the glory. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, we love you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, we worship you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Because he lives, we have hope.
Yes.
I said, because he lives, we have hope.
Yes, we do.
I don't know about you, but I'm looking for revival.
Yes.
I said, I'm looking for revival. America needs revival.
Yes,
America needs revival. And it's going to start with you and I. I said it's going to start with you and I. We can look left and right and forward and backward in politics and whatever, but it's going to start with us.
Yes, amen. The body of Christ.
Going to start with the body of Christ.
Yes, amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Honey, I love the Lord this morning.
Oh, hallelujah.
I love the Lord this morning. God is so awesome.
Yes, he is.
God is so awesome.
Oh, wonderful.
At the age of 10 years old, I asked the Lord Jesus Christ into my life. He not only saved me, he baptized me with the Holy Spirit and called me to the ministry the same night. I got up from the altar and I said, watch out, Billy Graham, here I come. I mean, I was so inspired by the fact that I could be used of God to make a difference in the world. And then I noticed something just a few days after that, that every singing group that came to sing in my church, I would cry like a baby. The Galileans, the Kings 3, the Latinos, all these groups from that era would come to sing in our church. I was crying like a baby. I didn't know why I was crying. I didn't know what the calling of God was. And I couldn't interpret what was going on. And all I knew is that I had to express myself. So I learned to play the piano, and I learned to sing and harmonize and teach harmonies and record and do all the things that had to do with music until when I was 15 years old. I met this 14-year-old girl that just stole my heart. She did goo-goo eyes at me, and I fell in love for the second time with the most meaningful relationship I would have in my life. And it's this woman right here. I'm feeling mushy this morning. She has been my girlfriend since the 8th grade in junior high. I carried her books through the 8th grade, the 9th grade. It was back then when, you know, you didn't have those backpacks. You carried them like this. How many of you remember that? Yeah, I see some of you old school remember that. And then her books and my books, so this is the way I traveled. And I take her to every class, 8th grade, 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade. And then I was 1 year ahead of her, so I graduated, went to Bible school in California. And guess what? She waited for me. Nobody waits nowadays, right? She waited for me till I finished my school, come back in my white horse and pick her up and
drove into the sunset.
I told you I was going to be mushy today. I was going to do this at the very end, but I'm still going to do the song at the very end. I wrote a song for her, and you guys are going to hear it and get to hold hands and all this mushy stuff. But I wrote something that I read it to her already, but I want to read it to y'all. To the best of my knowledge, I have calculated that you have been my wife for 16,425 days. You have been my girlfriend for 18,250 days. We have traveled more than 1,600,000 miles to date. We have worn out 18 vehicles, including cars, vans, motorhomes, and buses. You have kept your wedding vows to me as you have cared for me in sickness and in health, in good times and bad times, through success and through adversities. Through ups and downs, I can honestly say that we have had more highs than lows. So today, I honor you publicly by telling the whole white world that I love you and that, as the words of the song that we sang at our wedding says, yes, we've only just begun to live. White lace and promises, a kiss for good luck, and we're on our way. Before the rising sun, we fly. So many roads to choose. We start out walking and learn to run. And yes, we've only just begun. Sharing horizons that are new to us. Watching the signs along the way. Talking it over, just the two of us. Working together day to day. Together. And when the evening comes, we smile. So much of life ahead. We'll find a place where there's room to grow. And yes, we've only just begun.
Lend it to me. I have to say something. My husband started to write songs since he was 10 years old. And when I met him, I didn't know what I was in for. I loved the way he played the piano, and that's how I met him. And on our 20th anniversary, he wrote this to me, and I wish you could all see it. Maybe whoever wants to can, but as he was reading this to me, and then he handed it to me, when we got married June the 26th, 1971, we didn't have anything to our name. He didn't promise me a home. He didn't promise me anything, a brand new car. He didn't promise me anything, but he promised me that he would love me and he would take care of me. That wherever we were and wherever we would park our car or our van or our motorhome, that's where we were going to call home. And when he wrote, he showed me this, I was so blessed, because right after, on the 27th, we got married June the 26th, and the 27th, we left already on our way to San Francisco, California, and the road looked like this when we were traveling.
Lonely Texas
road. It was a lonely Texas road going all the way to San Francisco.
$77 in my pocket.
He had $77. And now we look back and I say, how did we do that?
Gasoline was 30 cents.
$77. Nowadays, you won't go out if you
don't have
$1,000 in your pocket. But $77. And as I was thinking about this, you know, I've traveled all these years. We've been together, doing everything together. And I consider myself a blessed woman.
Yes.
I've heard women come and tell me, they would look at my bus, and you travel 365 days out of the year? And I would say, yes. And you know, some of the women would tell me, oh, I'm going to pray for you. And I'm going to pray very hard, because I don't know how you could take this. But you know, it was a God thing. And it is a God thing.
Yes.
Because many of you wouldn't be able to do it. And I don't know how I do it. I don't know how I'm traveling 32 years and then pastoring for 12 and a half years. And then now come back again and start again traveling full time.
We've only just begun.
We've only just begun. And these are the words. And when I just found the words again, and I'm going like, Joel, you know, when 32 years ago, yes, I was in love. And the thing about being a wife was new to me, was exciting. But then after you go through what you go through in life, you think about it, wow. And I stand here today admiring and acknowledging my husband for being the priest in my home and for loving me the way that he's loved me. Yes, maybe I didn't have all the luxuries that a lot of women have asked for, but I know that I have his love. And I know that God is our provider, and he's been our supplier, and he's been our doctor, our lawyer, our everything. And today I stand here, and the words of this song that we picked, we've only just begun. It's just how we started, and we're back again together. We have a family. Yes, we have two children. They sang with us, but now they're on their own too, with their own ministries. And again, we've only just begun.
Yes.
And we're going to continue until the Lord says we're going to stop. And I don't think we're going to stop either. I think we're going to go with him before.
All right, mushy time. Every one of you that is married and sitting together, hopefully you're sitting together. Hold hands, hold hands. It's legit. Okay, you're in church. It's legit.
Now, if you're not sitting with your wife or your husband, you better run wherever they're at.
Go move whoever's next to them and say,
make
you
sure
know, this is where I've got to be.
Make sure that your wife sitting next to you.
Does a tree get tired of growing? Does a river get tired of flowing? Does a flower get tired of blooming? Then I'll never get tired of you. Can you touch the end of heaven? Can you ever touch bottom at sea? Do you know when the world is ending? Until then, you'll get true love from me. As the breath that I breathe every moment, as the sunset of every day, as the dawn of a beautiful morning, I will love you in every way. As the years take a toll of our bodies, we'll continue to change, no doubt. But your beauty is so much deeper, more than Clairol, I mean these eyes could tell you about. If my love could be measured this moment and compared to the day I met you, you would see what exactly I'm saying. So I'll say it again, I love you. I love you. Darling, I love you. You're the woman that God gave me. I love you. You've been a mother to my children, an example to them too. I draw strength watching everything you do. I love you. Darling, I love you. More than half of my life now, I have loved you. And right now I pledge my love, as I did in that small church when I said, my wife, I love you. I do. Darling, I love you. Honey, I want to thank you for all the years that you've stood by my side. Many times behind me, pushing me. Other times in front of me, pulling me. But most of the time, you've been there right by my side, where I've needed you the most. I want to thank you for all the miles and all the trials. And all the times you had all the right in the world to say, I don't want to go no more. But you never have. I want you to know that I love you and I appreciate you. I love you, darling, I love you. La mujer que Dios me ha dado, eres mi amor. Buena madre a mis hijos, un ejemplo sin igual. Con valor tú conquistas todo mal. Mi amor, te amo, mi amor. Continúas tras los años siendo mi amor. Y los votos que hice ayer, lo repito otra vez. Los que hice cuando dije, mi amor, te amo, mi amor. Honey, I can still hear the words, the minister's words when he said, do you take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife? To heaven to hold, in sickness and in health, till death do you part? And I said, I do. And I still do. I'm sorry. Somebody asked me the other day, he says, brother, when you do that up there, is that real or is it part of the show? I said, well, if it's not real, it sure has been a long show, don't you think so? The truth of the matter is that Rose and I are products of a Christian home. I thank God for mom and dad. I thank God for my in-laws that brought us to church by the hand, sometimes by the hand, sometimes by the ear, but we were always in church. I tell the people all the time, take them by the hand to the Lord's house. They don't want to go by the hand. Take them by the ear, because if you don't do that, when they grow up, they're going to take you by the ear to the courthouse. And whether you like it or not, they're going to call and say, Mom, Dad, stop by Wells Fargo and get all the money out so you can get me out of here. No, no, the Bible says train a child in the way that he should go. And then when he's old, he'll not depart from that. I thank God for my parents. They're already with the Lord, but guess what? They celebrated 71 years of marriage on this planet. Her parents are still alive. They just celebrated 66 years of marriage on this planet. We're celebrating 45 today, our daughter 24. Any questions? It works.
Yes, it does.
I remember even before our grandchildren were born, I tell the people, when my grandchildren are born, they're going to be Christians. And somebody challenged me one day, said, oh, come on, brother, how can you say that? They're not even born yet. And I got a little bit of that Christian, you know, when your hair goes up like that, what do you call it?
Corajito.
Coraje Pentecostal. And I said, wait a minute. I said, if I put an apple seed in your hand and I told you when you plant it, you're going to get apples, would you believe me? And he said, well, of course. I said, why? He said, well, because it's an apple seed. It's going to produce apples. I said, that's what I'm trying to tell you. This is a Christian home, and Jesus is the seed, and we're going to have new Christians when my grandchildren are born.
That's right. Amen.
That's the way it works. Man, I just feel like preaching this morning. I don't know why.
Go ahead. Praise God.
My parents thought that I was going to go to Bible school to become a pastor, and they never got to see me pastor. They passed away before I pastored, but you saw them move the pulpit a while ago, and really, this is my pulpit. The piano is my pulpit. Most of the songs that you're hearing, the songs that the Lord's given me from that pulpit, and I praise the Lord for that, because people ask me all the time, brother, you're going to sing and preach? I said, yeah, but we're going to do it all together, because instead of having one sermon, we're going to have like 10 or 12 sermons. Is that okay? 3-minute sermons. Oh, my. You know, I've learned something. In pastoring and evangelizing, I've been on both sides. So I can honestly say that I have the uttermost respect for pastors. They're 24-hour pastors, okay? Even when you're on vacation or asleep at night, you get interrupted, and that's okay because that's part of the job. But when you travel, it's different. When you're an evangelist, it's different. There's basically just two things that concern you when you're traveling. One is the physical, because it's, as my wife said, it's very physical. It's very hard. It's very, you're constantly carrying your bottle of Tylenol with you because you need it. It's hard. And you sleep when you can, you eat when you can, you sleep where you can, and et cetera. And the other is finances, because, you know, when you're pastoring, you have a salary, and when you're not pastoring, you don't have a salary. You just go down the road hoping that people will give. And that's the two things about evangelists, those are the two concerns. But as pastoring, I got to, fall in love with the people, and you get to, you know, when you're evangelist, you see the altar full and people, you know God's doing things, but then you love them and leave them, you know. And when you're pastoring, you get to see them grow. And I could stand on the platform and point to just about anybody and tell you a story about anybody that's in the, because you've seen their lives change and mature, and that's beautiful. And we had a church had a church because we turned it over to the Assembly of God District March the 6th, and we're full-time in evangelists again. And we had a very young church. We were the oldest in the church. We were the parents of most of them, because most of them didn't have their parents in the United States. And so we're mom and dad to just about everybody. And so we get to kid with them. And one day I told them, I said, I'm not going to pray for you no more. I mean, you're not used to hearing a pastor tell you, give up. You're hearing them say, don't give up. Oh, but give up and let Jesus. I said, give up and let Jesus take over. Oh, yeah. Give up and let Jesus take over. Let Jesus take over. Give up and let Jesus take over, and He'll make a way. You've got a mountain that you can climb, and if you've got a river that you can climb. Yeah.
and let Jesus take over. Give up,
yes, Lord,
and let Jesus take over. And he'll make a way.
Got a burden too hard to bear, and if
come on,
you've got a load
that's more than your share,
that's more than your share, kneel down.
There it is. Come on
and talk to Jesus.
Uh-huh. Oh yeah,
because he cares.
Oh, he'll make a way
somehow.
Give up and let Jesus,
yes, Lord,
take all. And let Jesus take over. Give up. And let Jesus,
yes, Lord,
take over. And yes, he will. I said, yes, he will. God, I have this big mountain, God. It's big, God, please help me with this big mountain. The doctor said, and God looks down and says, where, son, where's your big mountain? Where? I don't see it. I mean, from up here, nothing's big. Ooh. Where's your big mountain, son? I don't see it.
Oh, come on, Al.
Oh, wait a minute, son. I think I see it. Hold on. Yeah, they didn't do the carpet too good up here. Is this your big mountain, son?
Come on.
Oh, come on, son. You're insulting me. Don't you know that I'm a great big God?
Yes.
I'm bigger than any big size mountain.
Hallelujah.
Come on, son. This isn't big. Hey, why don't you stop telling me about your big mountain, and why don't you tell your big mountain about your big God?
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Because I can do everything.
Oh, yes.
There's nothing too big for God.
That's right.
Is there?
There's
no. Is there a sickness too big for God?
No.
Is there a problem that he can't solve?
No.
Have you seen that cartoon when this guy's laughing? You said that there's nothing big for God. He's laughing. Hello.
That's right.
You know, I wrote a song. I'm going to teach you a word. If you don't know Spanish, I'm going to teach you a word. Grande. Come on, say it with me. Hold on, honey. I've got to do a souvenir here.
grande eres tú. Yes, you are,
Señor.
En mi alma, en mi mente, en mi ser, Señor. Grande, grande, grande eres tú.
Oh, yes.
Grande, grande, grande eres tú, Señor de mi corazón. Grande eres tú en mi vida, en mi alma, en mi mente, en mi ser, Señor. Grandes son tus obras y tus maravillas. Grande y poderoso eres, siempre fiel. Tu misericordia, tu fidelidad es grande. Es tu fortaleza la que me sostiene. Es amor divino que mi alma llena. Tu misericordia, tu fidelidad es grande. Grandes son tus obras y tus maravillas. Grande y poderoso eres, siempre fiel. Tu misericordia, tu fidelidad es grande. Es tu fortaleza la que me sostiene. Es amor divino que mi alma llena. Tu misericordia, tu fidelidad es grande.
Because you're a grande God. We thank you, Lord, because there is nothing too big for you.
Grandes son tus obras y tus maravillas. Grande y poderoso tú eres, siempre fiel. Tu misericordia, tu fidelidad es grande. Es tu fortaleza la que me sostiene. Es amor divino que mi alma llena. Tu misericordia, tu fidelidad,
do it with us,
grande. Grandes son tus obras y tus maravillas. Grande y poderoso tú eres, siempre fiel. Tu misericordia,
here we go,
tu fidelidad es grande. Es tu fortaleza la que me sostiene. Y es amor divino que mi alma llena. Tu misericordia,
here we go,
tu fidelidad es grande.
Grande on, give it to Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Great is his faithfulness.
One day Jesus was talking to his disciples and he told them this. He said, "This and greater things are you going to do in my name."
Yes.
And the disciples probably looked at each other. It's not in the Bible, but they probably looked at each other and said, "What? I mean, he just rose Lazarus from the dead, and he's saying that we're going to do greater things? I don't understand." Well, they couldn't see into the future. They couldn't see into the time where you and I live. Because, you see, back then, if anyone needed Jesus, they'd have to go find him. And we don't have to go looking for Jesus. All we have to do is just call on his name. And he's right there 24 hours a day. Never goes on vacation. He never sleeps. He never slumbers. The disciples couldn't see into the future and see the cameras that are filming right now. And then later on, people will be able to see that. And if, when we're asleep, y'all are watching us. And the disciples couldn't see into the future and see that we were going to be able to make recordings. I said, we're going to be able to make recordings. Homes and their computers and on their electronic stuff. They couldn't see into the future. But we are blessed. We have been blessed that we have been recording gospel music since way back in the 60s. I mean, we go past CDs to cassettes. And then we went from past cassettes to 8-tracks. Some of you don't even know what an 8-track is. We go back to vinyl. The big ones. How many remember the little ones, 45s? We go that far back. We've been recording every form of music there is. And we have a lot of it with us, and we have one commercial. We're only give you one commercial, all right? You watch television for an hour, you get 50 commercials. We only have one. We have music on CDs. At the end of the service, you're able to buy these. Now, we didn't bring them all up here because we have just a lot of music back there. But I did want to tell you that we do have a lot of the songs that we've been singing on CDs. We've got Greatest Hits. Here's one, Greatest Hits. And we've got Greatest Hits in Spanish, Éxitos en Español, Oldies but Goodies. We've got Country, if you like country music. We have Grande, yeah, all right, Grande's on there. We have DVDs, we have videos, we have gospel classics, 4 CDs in one package here, and then we have DVDs, and we did one, this one here, I haven't even done this, honey. Can y'all, is it all right if I play one on the piano, just music a little bit? Yeah, all right, I have a CD, for those of you who like to pray with music. I love to pray with music, and I did a CD of nothing but music, that songs about prayer. And so you put that on there and forget the CD, because you can pray for an hour or so without changing the CD. All songs, it's called Quiet Hour. This is one of my favorites. And then we did something in last year, honey, Atlanta, Georgia. We did. How many of y'all seen the Gaithers, Bill and Gloria Gaither, and the Homecoming on television? You've seen them. Well, we did something similar with Hispanic artists, but we actually did something better than Bill Gaither, because Gaither can't sing in Spanish. And these CDs are 15, 2 for $25, and then we have 2 packages here, right? Have a $50 package, 5 CDs for $50, and then we have a $100 package that includes 5 CDs of your choice, the 4 classic CDs, classic music, and then 2 DVDs of your choice for $100. All of that, along with the offerings that you give to this ministry, helps us to be able to continue to do what we're doing. And of course, we covet your prayers, because without your prayers, we cannot do what we do, and we cannot continue to do this. Well, I'm going to do something on the piano. How much time do we have, brother? Are we going to 12? 12 o'clock? Yeah. Yes. All right. I fell in love with the piano at a very early age. My parents got me piano lessons, and before I knew it, I couldn't learn, so I just learned on my own. But this is one of the songs that's on the CD. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Somebody say praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Honey, come and sing this song here.
Give me your hand. Let's agree together that all of our enemies will crumble at our feet, that whatever we bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, at the name of Jesus Satan has to flee.
We've got the power in the name of Jesus. We've got the power in the name of the Lord. Those Satan rages, we cannot be defeated. We've got the power in the name of the Lord.
Tried to stop us, but the Church of Jesus is still alive. Like a mighty army, we keep marching onward, winning every battle with the Lord by our side.
We've got the power in the name of Jesus. We've got the power in the name of the Lord. Though Satan rages, we cannot be defeated. We've Dios el poder, en el nombre de Cristo. Tenemos el poder, en el nombre de Dios. Aunque el diablo ruja, no podrá derrotarnos. Tenemos el poder, en el nombre de Dios. We've got the power, in the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We praise you, Father. We praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you've made my soul a fountain. Living waters flow through me. But of lately I've been thirsting for this water for my needs. Lord, I know the source will not run dry. It's me that needs a fill. Won't you let your Holy Spirit fill me if you will. Feel the fountain. Oh Lord, for your coming is at hand. Give us courage, let us stand. At this hour, Lord, we pray. Feel the fountain. Out of time, Lord, you come so quickly. Your coming is at hand. There's no time to be on empty. Lord, there's such a great demand. I can see their saddened faces. I hear their desperate cry for the sake of those around me, Lord. Fill me, my fountain is dry. Feel the fountain. Feel the fountain, oh Lord, for our coming is at hand. Give us courage, let us stand. At this hour, Lord, we pray. Feel the fountain.
your coming is at hand. Lord, I need courage. I need to stand at this hour. Lord, we pray. Feel the fountain. We've come a long ways to bring you the message that this is the hour, this is the time, this is the moment when we need to stand. I said we need to stand. We need courage. We need to be able to stand. I don't think it's coincidence. Matter of fact, the word coincidence is not in God's vocabulary. Did you know that? There's no such thing as the word coincidence. God's vocabulary. It's not a coincidence that today you are here. I said you are here and we are here, and the message is clear. You see, we're living in the year 2016. We're living on borrowed time already. Jesus has not come because the numbers are not right, and the numbers are not right because you and I have been too complacent. I said, we've been too complacent. I don't mean this disrespectful, but I was driving up this morning and we were coming down the strip, and I saw all these churches, one after another, on this strip. And I couldn't help but tell my wife, make the comment, what does God do? Does he go into every one of those churches? Does he go on Sunday and visit every one of those churches? I remember when we started in the ministry back in the 1960s. I remember when 3 or 4 week revivals were common. Month revivals. People come every night for a whole month. And then somewhere along the way, they were cut down to 2 weeks. And then 1 week. And then we had weekend revivals. And then just 2 services on Sunday. And now, sad to say, 1 service on Sunday, and hope that we can get everything in there that we need to get into those 2 hours, because if the Lord himself wants to come and visit, he's going to have to wait in line for a place on the program. Oh, I'm not criticizing your church. I'm saying that we need to realize that Jesus Christ is about to come. And if he hasn't come, it's because we're not doing our job. I said, we're not doing our job. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you, Lord, asking that you would do what this song says. Feel the fountain. Feel our fountain. Our fountain, oh Lord, for your coming is at hand. Lord, we need courage. We need to stand at this hour, Lord. I don't know who you're speaking to this morning, Lord. I don't know, because I don't know the people here. But you know every heart. You know every thought. You know every intention, Father. Lord, we're not living in a time when we should live discouraged. But we're living in a time where we need to encourage those that need to be encouraged, Father. Lord, some of us sat to say our fountains are dry. And we need to pray, Lord, fill my fountain. Fill my fountain, Lord. Father, I pray for anyone that is discouraged today, Father. Maybe someone that has been working for you and it's already fallen into a routine. I don't know, Lord. I don't know the people here. Maybe complacency has set in place. Maybe we have forgot that you have come to this world to save the lost, and you would expect us to go into all the world and preach the gospel. And maybe we're not doing what we're supposed to be doing, Lord. I don't know. But you know, Lord, those that need for you to fill their fountain once again. Renew their spirit. Renew their joy. Renew the joy of salvation, Father. But Father, right now, even as your Holy Spirit is leading, Father, I pray that you fill those fountains that need to be filled right now, Father. That, Lord, that when we leave this place today, we would have known that we have been in your presence. And that you have spoken to our hearts. And we're not going to be the same. We cannot be the same. For you come for a church that is prepared and ready and without spot nor wrinkle. You come for your bride. You come for your bride. Fill my cup, Lord. Sing it with me. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup. Sing it again, but if you need to be at this altar is open. If you need to stand right where you are and just lift your cup and say, Lord, fill my cup while we sing this song, you do so, but feel the freedom to do whatever the Lord wants. Fill my cup, Lord.